Hi guys, welcome to the Swans Show. Coming up this week is me, Tammy Abraham. Let's start watching.
Tammy, you're a London boy. You've got the sun, sea, sand here in Swansea. You must have liked your time down here, haven't you?
Yeah, it's been good. Obviously, I live not too far from here, so I live on the beach as well. So it's always nice to look out your window and see such a beautiful view. And times like this, is just so beautiful.
And for the people who aren't from South Wales, it's always like this, isn't it, the weather here?
I haven't had a lot of sunshine, but it's not been too bad. I think it's just windy more than anything else. But yeah, it's nice weather.
You've been here since last summer.
Yeah.
Generally, how have you found it? Have you enjoyed your time at Swansea City?
Yeah, it's been good. I've had a lot of ups and I've had a lot of downs. And I think this is what kind of makes me become a man. And my first professional season in the Premier League, it's gone well for me. I've scored a couple goals and I'd like to score more. Hopefully, I do get a couple more before the season finishes. But like I said, I've had a lot of ups and downs. This is really what's going to build me for my next path.
Has it been tough, life in the Premier League? I know you'd had a little taste, hadn't you, at Chelsea before you came?
Yeah.
Is it harder than you expected or what you expected?
I think I've always, it's the best league in the world, so it's never going to be easy. It was always going to be tough for me. And I think that's where I've grown into a man now. Obviously, I've come from the Championship to the Premier League, which is two different leagues, and I've learned a lot. And I'd like to think that this, like I said, this would push me to and better me for my part in the future.
Do you think you're a better player now, Tammy, than when you arrived last summer?
I like to think so. I like to say I've developed in different aspects and I've learned so much things. I've come from obviously a side like Chelsea Academy to attacking football and just winning a lot of things. And coming here, it's been tough, like I said. I've learned different aspects for like defending and all sorts. And yeah,
it's different, isn't it, I imagine? Coming from one of the top academy sides to a club who are fighting to stay in the Premier League. Completely different kettle of fish.
Yeah, definitely. Like I said, I've had a lot of ups and downs and this is surely one of the best feelings. Obviously, now we're back to winning ways and all sorts. Hopefully we've outcome our losing path and hopefully we can move on from that.
You've got your England cap while representing Swansea, so that's clearly, you know, a big plus of the season.
Yeah, I think that was a big push for me, a big confidence boost for me as well. And it shows obviously I was doing something right and I just need to continue doing.
The manager's changed, of course. The man who signed you left halfway through the season.
Yeah.
Was that tricky for you?
I think it was always going to be tricky from when someone brings you in and a different manager comes in. It's always a different task and it's always you just have to keep proving yourself. And unfortunately, as you come, I've got injured as well. So didn't really help me, but like I said, I just have to stick with the team and do my best.
Yeah, it was a Watford game, wasn't it? I think you started, if I remember rightly.
Yeah.
Carlos Carvalho's first game in charge.
Yeah.
Then suddenly you're injured and you're sort of fighting to get your place back.
Yeah, definitely. Like I said, this is what makes me into a man. It was never just going to be a simple pathway, straight pathway. And like I said, I just have to be with the team. I just have to keep pushing and doing my best and keep trying to get into that team.
7 goals, I think you've got. Are you happy with that?
I wouldn't say happy. I'm happy with it. I'm not content with it. I'd like to score more goals. Obviously, like I said, the remaining games, hopefully I can get more goals for the team. And I'm always someone who believes and scores goals. So I just like to keep doing it.
Are you optimistic now, Tammy, that the end of the season is going to be good, not only for you, but obviously for the club? It's been a bit of a struggle, certainly in the first half of the season. But hopefully things are looking a bit brighter now as the sun comes out.
Yeah, things are looking better. Like the boys are playing with confidence and they've started to show what we're truly made of. And I think when we're losing games, we always knew it was going to be tough, but we always had to stick together. And that's what we've been doing, being quiet and the results have been going our way.
How do you see the picture in the bottom half of the Premier League now?
it's tight. You can never take your foot off the gas. I think for us, we just have to go into every game and believe we can win it, and we don't look down, we just have to keep looking up.
What about the FA Cup? Tottenham this weekend, the first time Swansea have been in the quarterfinals since long before you were born, 1964.
Yeah.
there's a chance, isn't there, to do something special in the Cup?
Yeah, there is. Obviously, a team like Tottenham, they're a fantastic team. We just have to be our A game, nothing less, because we know Tottenham, they won't come and just sit back, and they'll come with all guns blazing. So we have to do the same, and we have to believe. I think with the confidence we have, anything's possible.
You missed the game in the league, didn't you, I think, here?
Yeah.
But you played at Wembley, in the league at Tottenham.
Yeah.
If I remember rightly, you had to put a tough old shift in that day, but a great result for the team, 0-0 at Wembley.
Yeah, like I said, Tottenham are a top-class team. They're always going to play beautiful football, and they're going to try to score as much as they can. And I think that game, as I remember, first half game, I was so tired. They're always going to be a team like that. But for us, we just have to stick together, like I said, and they're coming to our ground. It's never going to be easy to get a win.
Jordan Ayew has obviously got sent off last weekend. He's going to miss the next three matches. Andre Ayew can't play in the FA Cup. So that's two big forward players who are going to be missing, certainly this weekend, and then Jordan for another couple. Mm. Have you looked at it and thought, this could be a chance for me? I hope so. A chance to sort of re-establish yourself in the first team?
Yeah, for me, I think every opportunity you're given, you have to try and take as much as you can. Even though it's against a team like Tottenham, you just have to do your best and go out and then express yourself and enjoy it. Some people take the enjoyment away from football. I think that's one thing that I need to get back doing, enjoying my game and just playing freely.
What does Carlos Carvajal say to you about you? He said to the media that he's spoken to you individually about where he wants you to improve, what he wants you to do.
Yeah, he's a manager that has great belief in me. And I read something the other day saying I need to be like Ronaldo, he said.
Which one? The older one or the Portuguese one?
I have no clue. Yeah. They're both pretty good players. Yeah, but for me, like I said, he sees good potential in me, and I have to achieve my potential. Every opportunity I'm given, I have to try and take it as much as I can.
What will make you happy, Tammy, when you're heading back to Chelsea in a couple of months? We don't know what will happen after that.
Yeah.
What will make you happy, though, in these last couple of months as a Swansea player for now, anyway?
I would like to say that I've done everything I can for Swansea, and I'd like us to obviously remain in the Premier League and for me to score a couple more goals for us as well.
Yeah, maybe another trip to Wembley as well. Maybe two trips to Wembley.
Maybe two trips to Wembley as well.
Yeah, that would be a nice end to what's been a positive year in your career.
Definitely.
Let's hope it happens, Tammy.
Thank you.
Good luck, my friend. Thank you. Swans staff are constantly looking for ways to help the club's players on the pitch. We find out why Swans' eyes are on the prize.
So regarding the eye test, what we're looking to do is we're looking at what their visual capacity is like, whether there's any issues that perhaps might need addressing. We obviously want to look at things that we can improve on, even if they've got perfect vision, perfect cognitive processing powers. Can we improve their capacity to think when they're fatigued, make better decisions? And if we can, hopefully that translates then into improved performances on the pitch.
So we had to focus on some tests. So the first one is to take the acuity, just to check if you have a good vision on both eyes. And then we try to find the binoculary perception. Do you have a little divergence, a little convergence? We all have a squint, but we are all struggling against it all the time because your brain wants to do the fusion of the two images. Then we check the color perception, we check the depth perception, 3D. And what we want to know is if you have a good calibration of eyes movement.
An eye test is just, you just want to know the vision of one eye or the other one. So they can say you're 20/20, you're 20/20, but we want to know how they work together, because you have two images in your brain and you create a second image, a third image, which is in three dimension. Of course, if you have the perception is quicker, if you can see things around you easier, you will be better, of course. And the thing is, you can't always turn your head to see the things, but if you can stay straight and see the thing without moving your head, you earn so many time. And so you can be at the good place at good time and catch the thing at the good time. Good time, this is it.
Now the players all had eye tests at the beginning of the season, but from what I understand, this is like a new level of eye test, like a Formula One, if you like, of eye test.
Yeah, I mean the guys obviously that we're working with have experience working in other sports, and Formula One is one of those sports. So essentially, it's looking at some of the commonalities that they see in our technical performance needs of the players, and things that they think they can influence in terms of. Visual training, cognitive training, that sort of thing. It's about understanding our players better, so if we do that, then hopefully we can responsibly innovate in terms of in what we provide for them to help them be the best they can be.
Swansea City claimed a hugely creditable point at Huddersfield Town last weekend, despite going down to 10 men after just 11 minutes. Jordan Ayew was dismissed after a tackle on Huddersfield midfielder Jonathan Hogg. Carlos Carvajal argued the two players made similar challenges and felt Ayew was unfortunate to see red. But the Swans reluctantly decided against an appeal, meaning Ayew will miss three matches, starting with Saturday's FA Cup quarter-final against Tottenham. The Spurs tie is not the only game at the Liberty this weekend. Swansea's under-23s look to continue their impressive season when they face Manchester United on Sunday at 1 p.m. Entry to the game is free.